don't know, I guess I want to be happy, I suppose. Maybe making some money. Probably could use some
5 years, at least, I hope, to be in Kelowna living with my brother. Probably working at Fat Daddy's Pizza, where he's working right now. At least that's what I hope to do in 5 years.
5 years, I'd like to be a teacher at Silver Heights, the best school ever.
Where do I want to be in 5 years? Hopefully out of school, maybe teaching here, all you guys, I don't know, something like that.
Beautiful.
In 5 years, I'll probably either be in university or working, hopefully making lots of money.
All right. 5 years, I got this plan for this band, and like my hit single, it's gonna go something like this, okay.
Five years about now, I'd say this explains everything.
I want to be rich and tanned and waited on hand and foot by Reed Westmacott.
I would like to be a professional pillow fighter making millions upon millions of dollars. That's about it.
Okay, in 5 years from now, if everything goes right, I plan on being in the military as an AVN technician, which I'm applying for as of right now. I should be leaving for basic training on June 30th. And if that all goes right, then that's what I'll be doing in 5 years.
Now I hope to be a flight attendant. And hopefully I'll be married to somebody rich, and that's about it.
5 years, I think I'd want to be sitting on a beach in Mexico, drinking as many coolers as possible with my favorite.
I hope to be touring with my band, Radio Silence.
5 years, I'll be sitting in the backyard of my home in L.A., Miami, by the pool, maybe putting suntan lotion on my rich husband.
In 5 years, I hope to be just completing university and traveling the world.
In 5 years, I hope to be very rich and famous. I don't know how, but I want to be rich.
In 5 years, I'll probably still be living at home, without a job, and basically just a bum. I'll have to depend on my mom all the time.
All right, well, where I hope to be in 5 years? Probably Ontario, Fanshawe College, OPP, or probably special guest appearance on Cops or something. I don't know.
Okay, I'm going to be a vet or a lawyer, or I'm going to marry Method Man and be a rap star named Shorty, and I'm going to own this school.
Where would I be in 5 years? Springer.
All right, in 5 years, I plan on being walking down the highway with guitar on my back.
Yeah, in 5 years, I plan on being in the RCMP, busting up all you guys.
I see myself as being a biology teacher at Silver Heights Collegiate.
In 5 years, I hope to be married to Darren Bomby and we'll both be on Springer, my transsexual husband.
Sure, why not? Okay, in 5 years, I hope to be a pharmacologist, so I can study the effects of drugs on people's brains, my friends' brains, maybe.
Okay. All right, in 5 years, I'm probably going to end up being on Springer with Darren and Melissa, being Darren's transsexual lover. You obviously saw the movie, and I love Darren.
Traveling with me. Hey now, hey now.
years, I just want to be traveling, and I don't know what I'm going to be doing.
Is stripping for money, and that's about it.
Hi. In 5 years, I'm going to be making independent films. Okay, in 5 years, I hope to be dancing on Electric Circus, because as you all know, Dan Hussey's got the moves.
In 5 years after I graduate, I'd like to be the guy who fills up the Coke machine in the foyer to have all the kids steal my Coke.
Just living the life.
In 5 years, I see myself as being the oil girl for the American Gladiator.
We did the full Monty for the fashion show, and we started off fully clothed in front of a bunch of parents, administration, and I guess we took off all our clothes and left in La Senza Uomo boxer shorts, they were called, but they were more like briefs, and it was, I guess it was my fondest memory. I don't know if it was really fun, but yeah. All right.
No, Crystal, it's on.
Our fondest memory of Silver Heights was...
Hey, Jude!
Fondest memory of Silver Heights...
was having Mrs. Russell as a secretary.
She was like a second mom to us, and we love her. Hi, Miss Russell.
I cannot put 4 great years at Silver Heights into one little memory. Hold on. All right, cut. Let's do it again. I cannot put 4 great years at Silver Heights into one memory.
I've only been at Silver Heights for 2 years, but what I can remember are all the great people I've met, friends I've made, and that's about it.
My fondest memory of Silver Heights would probably have to be hauling my ass up on stage for the talent show, and I don't know why I did it. I guess because it's grade 12 and I can't, and I had nothing to lose. That and cheerleading, that would have to be it.
Okay, my best silver memory is probably my worst, because I fell out of my desk, thanks to Chad Pincus, and I accidentally grabbed some guy's butt. Sorry, Hugh Fraser, I didn't mean to. Wasn't my fault. I also had to do a 5-minute speech on gonorrhea. Thanks, Mr. McNeil.
Our
fondest
memory
of
Silver
Heights
is
the
boys
Husky
hockey
team.
Go Huskies!
Okay,
What do you think the fondest memory of Silver Heights is?
Well, personally, my fondest memory was watching Crystal Jans and Alexi Olsen have one hot smooch.
Oh, that was great. That was just killer.
One of our fondest memories of Silver Heights was May Long 99 at Victoria Beach.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, how you doing? That's it.
My fondest memory of Silver Heights is probably meeting Matt and also our senior trip to Weyburn, Saskatchewan with the cheerleading team.
I would have gotten suspended at least once.
What we would want to do differently at Silver Heights
is to fail some classes so we'd have more time to party because we'd still be in school.
Okay, what I would have done differently is absolutely nothing, because if I would have done anything different, I'd be a different person than who I am now, which would be not what I want.
Shannon, if there's one thing you could have changed during the senior year, what would it be?
I think I would have studied for at least one biology test.
Actually, Shannon, we're supposed to be running a biology test right now.
Sorry, Mr. McNeil!
My school is on our trip to Weyburn. I would have picked up some of those cute guys. And that's it.
Throughout high school, I wouldn't have left my keys in my car 3 times and locked them in there. I also left it running, so I wouldn't have done that either.
If I changed one thing from high school, I would have learned how to stay on the road while I was driving.
Okay, if there was something I would have done differently in high school, I would have tried harder in all my classes.
Coming to you.
If I could do high school over again, I wouldn't waste 3 years at Westwood. I would have came to Silver Heights in grade 9.
Differently in high school, I wouldn't have worn that big, ugly dress with a humongous bow across it for the fashion show, and then the zipper broke, and then I got a bleeding nose, and I wouldn't have changed in full view of all the boys when they came off the stage.
Well, I did a lot of stuff that people probably would think I would regret, like I shaved my head and a couple of other stupid stuff, but I don't really regret doing it. It's a learning experience, I guess. Sounds kind of corny, but I don't regret it at all.
Look at this.
If there was one thing I could do differently in high school, I would have maybe done some work, because every year, grade 9 to 12, I did nothing all year, and then exams come, and I realized, I've done nothing all year. I'm screwed. And then I get all stressed out, and I don't have a good time. So maybe that's what I would have done.
If I could have done something different in high school, I would have hung out with the girls more and I would have been a little more rowdy when I was younger.
If I could do something differently in high school, I would have made fun of all the jocks who made fun of me in grade 10, and I would have kicked their ass.
I really wouldn't have changed too much about high school because I really don't care what people think about me, and other people should feel the same way.
If I could do it all over again, I probably would have grown my hair the whole time.
If I had to do it all over again, I probably wouldn't have turned down Scott Grassi's wedding proposal.
If I had to do high school differently, I would have gotten more involved in sports and student council.
Did you like that looking up at the script?
Well, if I could do it all over again, what I'd do differently is I wouldn't have taken a shower after the fashion show at Ashley Snickers' party. You guys know what I'm talking about.
Am I on? I would have combed my hair and studied, probably. That's about it.
Done something differently in high school. I guess I wouldn't have started that fire last year. I also would have started more fires. One way or the other.
What the heck kind of question is that? I had fun.
Okay, I wouldn't change anything about what I did in high school because anything that I did would have changed the outcome, except maybe writing the IB exams, because they were a pain in the butt.
All right, in the last 4 years, if there's anything I would have done differently, it would have been Mr. McNeil. He would have had a lot more purple nurples. A lot more. He'd be in pain. Just
grab and not let go.
Deluded Jalunis, this is it. You've made it. Good for you. In spite of all the teachers and yourselves, you've made it. My advice to you is give it hell, give it the best, have confidence in yourself, and bless you in the future. Good luck.
Okay, to the graduating class of 1991, the last one of this century, my advice would be from an old guy who's retiring now. Life goes by very, very quickly, so make sure you enjoy what you're doing, do what you enjoy, and take advantage of it.
As a retiring teacher, I have three things to say to the graduating class. Kind of a military metaphor. Remember three things. Keep your powder dry, stick to your guns, and don't fire until you see the whites of their eyes. Good luck.
Hello, graduates. I want to tell you it's been a pleasure working with all of you. This whole graduating class impresses me as having an awful lot of talent. So, go for it. Go out there next year. Give it all you got. Have fun. Stay out of trouble. Don't push any panic buttons. Congratulations. Have a good one.
Dream weave a chain.